I want to return now to one of our other big stories, a SARS court appearance today. And reporter Erin Bates was in court this morning, is going to give us a quick update. So there were three, Ivan Pillay, Johan van Lochrenberg, and I think Andries Janssen van Rensburg are the three. Remind us what the summons was about and why they appeared in court.
So they were summoned in March, they were summoned last month, and these allegations relate to an operation in 2007. The accused, stand accused of bugging NPA offices in 2007 and then passing on or arranging a payment of 100,000 rand to the person they believe is responsible for this bugging in 2008. So those two charges there, and these relate, or the charges are being kind of pushed forward under RICA and then an act that deals with criminal activity.
Bugging with what intention? This was all part of something called Project Sunday something.
Sunday afternoon.
Sunday afternoon, yeah.
So this is all to do with the rogue unit at SARS, and there's been so much controversy around it, whether it was in fact a rogue unit, whether it was conducting legitimate work in order to try and prosecute serious tax evasion, including amongst politically exposed people, organized criminals, tobacco smugglers and the like. But it all relates to the time when Jackie Salebi was being investigated and whether or not this unit at SARS was acting within its mandate or if it was overstepping the mark and going beyond its call of duty and in fact the law.
Am I correct in saying that Trevor Manuel at some point was also dragged into this?
He was. At the end of last year, he was asked to provide an affidavit to the Hawks in relation to this case, and the NPA is now pushing this matter through. It has been remanded until the middle of the year, at which point it will be moved to the High Court. So we're going to move from the Magistrates Court in Pretoria to the High Court. But essential to the matter for the accused and their counsel is to actually get the docket with the full charges that they're facing. They were asked to give sort of answering affidavits and give warning statements in the matter, but they haven't seen the full docket, and that's something they're expecting in the next couple of weeks.
So fairly procedural as we expected today. Do we have a sense of who the witnesses might be?
We have a sense of two of the witnesses and two very crucial witnesses in this case. The one is Jonas Makwakwa, who decided to resign from SARS on the 14th of March, citing personal reasons. Of course, there was a big cloud around him because he'd been investigated by the Financial Intelligence Center and fingered over allegations of money laundering and corruption. And then also Tom Moyane, who was fired as SARS commissioner by the president on the 20th of March. Two of the state witnesses in this case, and one of the conditions of the accused being allowed out without any bail, just a warning at this point, is that they don't interfere with those state witnesses before the next appearance.
Don't suppose you had a chance to talk to any of them?
We did, and in fact there was a flurry of activity outside court when
I'm surprised, yes.
Black First, Land First were there heckling the lawyer counsel for the accused in this matter, so Bernard Holtz of Vakman's attorneys giving a statement, and also Pindi Lowe from the NPA asking, I asked her if she was confident that the NPA was not being used as a political tool within the context of kind of consternation and battles at SARS. She said if they didn't have a strong case, they wouldn't be going to court.
Erin Bates, thank you very much indeed.